Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over some Excel shortcuts I use frequently. And FYI, I'll be showing you these using a Windows-compatible keyboard. So I got hooked on keyboard shortcuts years ago when an instructor talked about how much time could be saved by using keyboard shortcuts instead of reaching for your mouse all the time. Because even if it takes a second to reach for your mouse, that time adds up if you reach for your mouse over and over again. Plus, I really like how people seem impressed when they see stuff happening on the screen and it looks like you're not moving. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So let's get started. So to quickly jump from the beginning to end of a consecutive range, use Ctrl and either the left or right arrow to move left to right or right to left. And likewise, you can use the up and down arrow to move either from top to bottom or bottom to top. You can toggle from the beginning of your document to the last of your data by pressing Ctrl Home or Ctrl End. Highlight a row by pressing Shift Space, or highlight a column by pressing Ctrl Space. Use Ctrl A to highlight a selection. Press Ctrl A a second time to highlight the entire spreadsheet. If your workbook has multiple worksheets, use Ctrl Page Down to scroll to the right. Use Ctrl Page Up to scroll to the left. To quickly sum a selection, you can press Alt and the equal sign. And notice how you can do this for both columns and rows. You can press F2 to step into your cell or formula and edit the contents of a cell. To insert a paragraph break or a blank line, you can press F2 to step into your cell and then Alt-Enter to add those blank paragraph lines. Quickly hide a row by pressing Ctrl-9 and hide a column by pressing Ctrl-0. Just make sure to use the numbers above the letters, not the ones on the number pad. And lastly, in many Office programs, not just Excel, you can select menu items by using the Alt key. Notice what happens when I press Alt. All of these letters and numbers show up along my tabs. From here, choose the one you need. For example, pressing Alt and H brings me to the Home tab. Let's say I press the number 1 next. Notice how I just bolded the contents of my selected cell. Similarly, anytime you see a letter in a command underlined, press that letter on your keyboard. For example, let's say I am using my mouse and I right-click. Notice how you see several letters underlined. Pressing the letter underlined for the command that I need executes that command. So I hope you found this tutorial on time-saving Excel keyboard shortcuts helpful. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.